Hello everybody, today I will be checking out a game called Tyrant Unleashed. It was requested by one of my viewers, so I decided to cover it. I play Tyrant Unleashed myself, and I have been playing it for already 9 months minimum. And this is basically not the first time I'm playing something from Tyrant series. And I have some opinions to say about this particular game. You probably can see this, but I have rated this 1 out of 5 stars. Not a very good rating, I'd say, but I believe this game deserves it. Because basically, it's an okay game, but it tries to ask the players to pay a lot of money on it. And the costs in this game are literally pretty extreme, I'd say. And I will soon go to that part, but I will start from the very beginning. As you can see, this says Tyrant Unleashed. Some time ago it would be completely the same picture, except on the bottom it would say that we are celebrating 4 years. 4 years anniversary, and 4 years anniversary was exactly 1 year ago. So for about 1 year, it was this icon being shown to me, and it would say, "We are celebrating 4 years. Yes, yes, yes." Oh, and here comes the music. Oh, will I have enough time to spend all that money? Oh, let's look at the prices very quick. Oh, wrong tab. By the way, this music is very repetitive, I probably will turn it off, I'm just showing it off. Okay, where's my warbones? Oh, how do I find them? Here we go. So, here are the prices. And this is with the discount. So basically, if you want the best deal, you pay $99.99. That is $100, $100 to get usually 1,000 barbons, but in this case it will be 2,000 barbons. Wow, best value. Let's see what we can buy with it. Oh, really quick. Okay, a box. So one pull in a box costs 60 barbons. So if you get, if you got 1,000 barbons, you will be able to make at least 15 purchases, I believe. Maybe more, I'm not very good at math. But look at this. Will these numbers around here mean that I will have to buy two of these? And everything is random. So basically it means that I can get some crap, and the likelihood for me to get crap is incredibly high. Because for example, look at this card. It's just a random card, but this system of boxes has a thing called the fusions. Basically now I would get, for example, this card, and I would need to get four same copies of the same card so that I could fuse them together into one quad card. And in this case it would be this one. Basically, I need to buy a box at least 4 times, and because everything is random, and because there's just so many different cards, I would need to spend a lot of barbons just to hope to get one quad out of this. So basically, there are just a couple quad cards, and they are pretty okay, I guess, but the chance of getting just one single card, one unfused card, just very very high. So anyways, I will turn off my music right now. It's quite getting on my nerves. Oh, music is off. Yeah, done. And by the way, the only way to get barbons is to basically buy them. If you are a free player, you should get around 250-300 barbons. But if you are very patient, like for example, I was patient, I waited 1 year nearly, and now it's 5 year celebration time. As you saw before, Loading screen. It's still the same screen for 40 anniversary, except they eliminated the line saying "We are celebrating 4 years." So just the fact that for 5 years anniversary they didn't bother to make new artwork, it just says, well, maybe these developers are giving up on this game. So yes, I'm speaking a lot, and there's a lot of stuff to cover. But now, real quick, I probably will be showing one last thing. So here we go. These are mythic cards. Mythic rarity. Rarity exclusive to pay-to-win players. We used to call them that name. Free-to-play players, where people who don't spend money, are capable to get one mythic card, mythic rarity card. And I will show you this one. So I don't know if you saw the stats on some of the other cards, but this card is already pretty outdated. And in Tyrant Unleashed, this is a very common trend. Because basically, this game, once it was released, it had very weak cards compared to today. Maybe are balanced, maybe are fun to play. But developers really wanted that pay-to-win players would continue buying new cards, so they just increased the card values to a very extreme level. Okay, here we go. Oh, I will show you some cards. So these are the starting cards, more or less. This is a common card, and quick, here we go, or not. Okay, somewhere around here I will find the rares. This one. This one is rare card. Can you see something below? 8 hit points, 3 attack. Well, that's very low basically. And also commanders. Look, 12 hit points. Just 12 hit points. The values are very low. And for example, I can upgrade stuff, so I will quickly show to you. Here we go. And I use stuff like this to create my ultimate fusions. Like for example, this card is weak. This card is completely pathetic. But it was released originally to free-to-play players, and developers didn't bother releasing any new cards for a base set. Basically, having the same card set as base for. Well, for all the existence of this game, these cards we released, and 5 years later, we're still getting the same cards. So, the good thing about them is that we can fuse them. Like for example, this particular card is Event Reward, but this card is made from base fusions, from base cards. Like, I upgrade this dude to maximum, upgrade this card Tiamat to maximum 2. And I fuse them, and I get this card. And when I repeat the same process, get a second copy of Bailiff card, and I fuse them again, and I, oh my god, I get an upgrade. Or maybe not, wait a second. Oh yeah, this one. The ultimate card. And this is recent fusion, so it's kinda good. So, 78 hit points, 22 attack. So, one thing is that this game has got campaign, as you can see, energy systems. Beautiful! So great! And the costs are great too. Look, 55 costs to do one mission. So that's very cheap, by the way. So, and all the missions go fast too. Okay, here we go. Oh, this one. So the best paying missions required 200 energy. Basically, to complete a mission, you can just beat it once. But if you want better rewards, you beat it 5 times. If you want to even better rewards, you beat it 10 times. So that's one no, 2,000 energy. Yes, my math is correct. So basically, 2,000 energy, and 1 energy is 1 minute. So to complete this from level 1 to level 10, I would require a lot of attempts. I mean, to go back again and again and again and again and just. Who's coming back non-stop. So if I want to just have fun, I just go here, I play this mission twice, That's it, done. I'm complete for the day. I will need to wait 6 more hours to play this experience again. Also, this mission has been added 1 year ago somewhere. And in the meantime, the currents have gotten very strong, very good, very amazing. So this mission is a joke. Basically, I can complete this mission of no auto skip. And this is how most of my battles go through, because they are either very easy or very laborious to do. So there's a lot of auto skipping involved in this game. Grind. This is a grinding game to its very core. Of course, if you are a paying player, I will go back to store. You can buy energy increases. Of course, that's a great thing. There we go. If I wanted my energy increased by 50 more energy, I would buy this thing. I would spend 500 war bonds. And what's the price for it? Oh, for only $50. For only $50. I could experience the joy of playing this game for 50 more minutes. Oh, I would need to do log in much less frequently, thanks to this expenditure of $50. $50 on this game. And basically, I would now, if I bought that stuff, I would have now not 400, but 450 energy. So I still would need to do this mission 2 times. And I would be more or less empty. But the kicker is that I will not need to wait 400 minutes, but 350 minutes, man. And when it will go back to 400, and when I play it twice, I will be out. And then I could wait either 400 minutes or 450 minutes. If you know what I mean. Basically, this energy limit is a great limitation on how much fun you can have with the game. Now, there's one thing which doesn't cost energy. So, it's fighting your guild mates. Here we go, here we go. I will fight one of my dudes. Oh, let's battle this one. So, we are now going to battle mode. And this is free of energy. But basically, we are only 50 players in the guild. So, we are only 50 different choices on who to attack. You don't get anything from this. This is zero. The only enjoyment is, wow, I beat that guy! Wow, I had a difficult fight! Yes! But I got zero for it. Also, I have been playing for 9 months, so in that time, I became a top free-to-play player. And in my guild, a lot of players are not as tough as me, so basically, we are only a couple people who could give me any challenge. So, this gets old very quick. Okay, here we go. Oh, battle! Oh, I will not skip. Okay, let's turn this to original speed. Also, if the music will be turning on, where's the menu music? That's one thing. When there's a regular mission music, that's second music. And the third music track is boss music track. And all of these tracks are somewhere around a minute in length, maybe shorter. So basically, the music is very repetitive and it gets under my skin very quickly. That's why I turn it off most of the times. So here we go. Basically, at any given time, I'm choosing from these 3 cards. So there's a lot of choice, a lot of freedom for me to make. Oh, and now a card is in the play. Here we go. This is such a fast speed. Very well thought of. The battle is intense. My goodness, is this intense? Wow! Well, of course, these cards have skills and stuff, but I mean, if you would like to play this game, you will find it out for yourself. Like, for example, this card is very quick, so it attacks immediately. Okay, let's speed this up. Now it is at twice the speed. Wow! This is getting so fast. Another card. Okay. Well, I guess now I'm going to the ultra speed. Okay, I'm gonna go fast, baby. Oh. Come on. And by way, this particular card is mythic. So this my guildmate has spent some money on this game, I believe. And he got this powerful card. So basically, this he put one card. It was called Adjutant, something like that. And that card summoned this monster. And this monster basically has a skill called Drain, so it regenerates all of its health. And this card has Berserk. So the more damage this card deals, the more damage it's going to deal the next time. And the more damage it deals, the more health it gets. So basically this is a more or less invincible card. And the free-to-play players just need to hope that they will be fast enough to heal. Like this time, for example. That's very lucky. So anyways, this is the battle. Now I'm just auto-skipping this because, well, it's pretty boring overall. And there will be plenty of mana to play very soon. So, I guess it's time to cover the upgrade system. I guess I talked about it. So now the costs. Wow, they are impressive. Basically, to upgrade the card, you need to spend 5 salvage points. After that, you spend 15. After that, you spend 30, I believe. After that, 75. And finally, 150. So to upgrade one card fully, you need 275 salvage points. And to fully quad one simple card, the cheapest is, I believe, something near to 2000 salvage points. And basically, these salvage points are very slow to get by. Basically, yes, I have 1 million gold, but I saved this much gold in around... what is it? Couple months. Because free-to-play players don't get that much interesting stuff, so I got myself whatever I could. And in the meantime, I'm just saving all the money. Oh, another interesting trivia, which I will soon say. Okay, yes, card limits. There's only a certain amount of cards which I can have in my deck. So, now I can have maximum 660 cards in my deck. At first it was 600, but I purchased card slot upgrades. That was the only other thing I could spend my gold on. And I spent 76,000 gold to go from 600 maximum cards to 660. Wow, that was a 10% increase. Amazing. Literally beautiful. So I guess I could talk about rewards because we have some events. And these events happen on a weekly basis, so on every weekend you can get some stuff. So, this card I got from as a reward, as you can see, it's very weak and very pathetic. And that's often the case, because most of the rewards are very poor quality, not needed, complete trash most of the time. Especially if you're playing this game for a pretty long time. I actually even know one particular saying when it comes to this specific game. And that particular saying is that if you get it, you don't need it. And I forgot the exact saying, but it's something, if you earn it, you don't need it, because oh yeah, I remember. I took some sort of searching and finally it came to my mind. If you earn it, you don't need it. If you get it, it's just useless crap. If you work hard for something, the effort is simply not worth it. Because you probably don't play this game, but basically, in order to get this card, you need to near perfect performance. And in this particular event, to get that far, you need to have pay to win decks, mostly, for the most part. So, yeah, my guild, for example, probably will have to deal with some crappy card. There are some crappy cards. I see some potential in them, but, for example, one event it is most likely to give only 2 copies of a card, so it's necessary to wait 2 events sometimes. Some events will only give me one copy of the card. And if card is supposed to be very good, the chance is that my guild or I personally will not get any of these Vindicator rarity cards. So there's a lot of rewards, which may be good for free to play, but if you are paid to win, you get the cards if you are paid to win, but if you pay to win, you don't need them. And if free to play needs these cards, they cannot get them. So these rewards are more or less a joke. Salvage material, more or less. Basically, people participate in these events for bragging rights. They say, "Wow, my guild was first! My guild was second! My guild was third!" And so on, etc. Basically, I might be forgetting something, so let's get to action. Special events! Yes! Oh, look at that art! Beautiful! Oh, and also, we are 142 missions, mainline story. And we are all a joke. And we all cost pretty high energy costs, so this is a grind at its finest. Okay, I will go back and see. So now I managed to maximize around 110 missions. Maybe a little bit more, but there's still 30 more missions to go. So basically all of this took me 9 months. 9 months and I have still not maxed out all these missions. And we are all a joke. We're all easy, we all auto skip material. And I will also something about this quest rewards. This reward is crap. I've been already going for this reward for 9 months. And the chances are that I will still need to go 6 more months or something close to that to get this card. This card was released somewhere around 1 year ago. Maybe 2 years ago, I don't remember exactly, but the point is players needed to wait for a very long period of time to get this card. For example, right now for this card I need to do this quest, and this quest requires specific type of event, and that specific type of event happens something like 6 weeks, every 6 weeks, maybe every 8 weeks. So basically, and one event is not enough to complete this quest, so I need to wait nearly 3 months to complete one quest. And basically, there are like 4 such grindy quests in this quest strand. So, there's like 1 year of just waiting and doing nothing, and then it's just a couple of weeks when things get done. And all of this just for 1 week card. Of course, it could get upgraded. That's why I'm personally going for it. Because developers of this game release realized that their old cards are getting crappy, so they thought, well, if we upgrade these new cards, these old cards, we won't have to do any new artwork. Yes, we save the money. That might not be the case. But there's a lot of evidence that developers are spending less and less effort on creating artwork. For example, this card has the same art for all 3 versions of it. Single version, double version and quad version. Like for example, I will show you one older card. Oh, here we go. Oh, I hope I remember this one. And here it is. Look, this is single version. Single version. Wow, single version upgraded a bit. Now that's dual version. And that's quad. So basically, in the old days, all these cards would get 3 different sets of paint job. Now, it's mostly only 2 paint jobs, and sometimes the developers and the artists only make 1 paint job. So this is getting more and more lazy. And also these missions, for the most part, make little to no sense. There's just some random stuff going on. Like, for example, in the last event cycle, the campaign, the temporal campaign of last event cycle, involved the journey through a mountain, and nothing was happening. You just were fighting some bad dudes. Basically, what was happening was, we need to keep quiet. We must not alert one very powerful monster. We must do everything we can to avoid alerting that monster. And that was like 6 weeks of action. Yeah, will we alert the monster or we will not? And basically, that was the story for that particular event. And for this temporal missions, it's basically a repeat of old bosses. Yeah. And basically, the story for this is just a reminder what was happening in the past. How things were going on then. Just a reminder. I haven't been around, so I don't know like what exactly happened with this dude. But the mission text would say a long wall of text about characters I don't care about. About events which I don't really care about. Because the amount of text is just too short. We are no pictures, only text. So very boring overall. Okay, I've been going for this very long. Oh, by the way, this mission costs 55 energy. This is a boss. This is supposed to be the ultimate challenge that these temporal missions have to offer. Here we go. 55 energy spent. Here comes the battle. Here comes the action. Oh my. Oh my, look at that incredibly tough card. 34 hit points, 8 attack. 39 hit points, 4 attack. Look at those numbers, look at my numbers. Look at these numbers, look at my numbers. Those cards are trash. They used to be good, but they are no longer that. Oh, here we go, and here's the boss. The boss cards. In any given event cycle, there are three temporal bosses, and they are released in three phases on three different dates. So the first boss has two cards, two special cards, let's call them A. Second boss has two cards B and one card A, and third boss has got one card A, one card B, and two cards C. So that's four bosses on the ultimate challenge. And all the other cards are jokes like this one. Completely joke. By the way, I'm not even getting to the regular missions released during this cycle. Because it's basically even worse than this. This might look to you, oh my god, this is easy, where's the challenge at? Those missions, when the regular ones, they released basically this card. Is what you are fighting all the time in basic missions. And in the tough missions, basically these weak cards plus some tougher cards. So basically those tougher cards are usually more tougher than regular cards. So there are some very tough cards which are very unfair to deal with. If you get them on first turn, you basically lose or have a lot of trouble. And then there are joke cards. So all of this gaming experience feels like a complete grind, like a complete luck based. Because this particular mission only has three bosses. Well, this is basically true. I could keep going like, but what's the point? What's the point of this? Auto skipping this bad boy. Yeah. Now. Okay, I guess I will take some time to auto-skip. Auto-skip all the time, auto-skip all the time, like there was no tomorrow. Oh, here we go, finally we are done. Okay, wait a second. Okay, so now that's the moment. Raid time! Of course, maximum energy limit. And this one recharge in 12 hours. So this one allows people to take a nap, to sleep a bit, maybe exercise a bit in the morning, brush with teeth, and etc. But basically, this is event. This is supposed to be competitive. This is supposed to check the quality of player skill. How good the guilds are at completing these events. And look at this, look, you see that plus sign? You know what it means? Yeah. You want your refill? Buy it. Oh, and it's only 5 war bonds. I'm not buying that. I will quickly check. Oh, by the way, this is boss. All the cards are randomized. Basically, they are always the same cards, but they could be somewhere from level 1 to level 10 strength, depending on the raid level. So, basically, look, this is a joke card. These are the tough cards. Basically, this is a Russian roulette. So again, I need to go to the bucket. I don't know if I have the willpower to play through all of these places. 24 battles. 24 battles, so playing against one boss. Maybe I will just manual play, but we'll skip as much as possible. Oh my. Oh my. Overlord 9, Struggle 12, Protector 8, etc, etc. All the good stuff. Yeah, and these cards of course have some skills. I was probably upset I could talk about the skills, but I don't feel motivated for it. Well, because if you really like the game, you can just play and find for yourself what each skill does, because most of these skills have an introduction tutorial about. This video is more about the experience, the joy of going to Tyrant Unleashed. And as you can see, a lot of regular battles for me go like this. Okay. So, I guess I could use some strategy, but... and I do use strategy when I do play seriously, but... the nature of repetitiveness in this game is just so extreme that... it gets bored very quick. Like, come on. Oh my, such a tough card. Basically, a lot of these cards, like for example, this one is maximum now. Maybe it's not very tough, but look at hit points. And those hit points far exceed what I have. So basically, all these cards are on steroids. So the difficulty is not through skill combinations. Maybe in part, the difficulty is some sort of deviation from skills, but mostly just high numbers. What are the highest numbers that you can deal with? Basically, some time ago, there was another raid released, maybe 6 weeks ago, and it was so tough that only 2 guilds managed to reach the maximum level. That was only done with maximum purchase of refills. Okay, here we go. Maybe I will just auto-skip from this point. Well, it doesn't matter, I guess, whether we win or lose. So now, let me check again. Oh, now it's 35 cost. Impressive. I want a refill. So it's 1 try, 5 war bonds. I will just quickly remind you. To retry all this stuff, you need $10. That is $10. I had nearly full stamina bar, so I'm spending $10. What I have is worth $10. Wow. So these prices are incredibly interesting to look at. Because I personally don't have that much money for this game. And the costs are extreme, like compare this to any AAA game release. Compare it even with all the microtransactions that most games sometimes have. This is still going to be more extreme. I guess this is a grind to its maximum. But I guess need to put this experience straight into our hearts, minds, souls, and spirits. Just to get experience how grindy this can be. I'm auto-skipping. I'm auto-skipping to infinity. I'm auto-skipping like there was no tomorrow. Oh, this is such a great experience. This is such a great joy to go through. So much fun to be had. And by the way, these backgrounds are very repetitive. You basically need to be prepared to deal with this again and again. Oh, a loss! Wow. Well, I'm already losing it to level 16, so I'm already one of the top players, so imagine how does this feel for a beginner. Basically, beginners start with crap. I showed you those weak cards with like 10 hit points, etc. So beginners start with those cards, and we need to keep going from there. So I need to participate in these events and get some rewards from these events. Or hope that we get some good quality pulls from basic packs, and that we have enough salvage points to fully upgrade them to something useful. It was unlikely, so for the time being, the new players would have to deal with the feeling of having a deck. The deck might look good. The deck might look fun to play, but then they see a card. They see a card. And we see the position, and the position looks something like this card in particular. Look at this card. See this card and they can do nothing. One card basically destroys whole deck. Because basically beginners start with complete crap. They start as if it was 5 years ago. But we have some new cards, and to get those cards, players needed to participate in events. Like for example, new players in this raid, we are feeling almost everything. First level was okay, maybe second level too. But after that, every single battle is a loss because we are just the beginners, because we just merely have started the game. Because I merely just got into it and my card is such shit. And we need those cards to get something good. So if they lose everything, they might hope to get one good card out of this. Okay, maybe two cards. Maybe three, maybe something, but that's very few cards. And keep in mind, to make a quad, you need four cards. Four cards! So just because you got one card, it means that you are still crap. Because this is single version maxed out. This is quad version maxed out. As you can see, the skills go up, and in a battle, quad will always defeat mono card. Also, we have five factions, and there's one ultimate faction, which could go with any of those factions. So, this is Xena, Xena, whatever, this is Bloodthirsty, whatever that is, Raider. Basically, some of the skills are faction-specific, like cards. Like, for example, this card has skill Allegiance, so it gets its health and attack increased if it has the same faction card played. So the more Bloodthirst being played, the better for this particular card. But the cards for free-to-play players are being released few and fine between. So basically, if you're going mono faction, you will have a repetitive deck, and that deck will be constantly behind the people who choose to go rainbow, which means all factions. So if you want to stay competitive, you need to forget going for mono faction for the most part. Unless you are me and you saved 1 million gold, and good for you, I guess you can go mono faction for one cycle. And after that, maybe you will save another 1 million and will be able to go another cycle for another mono faction. Because we have some good mono cards released, but they are not released frequently enough. A lot of new cards releases are crap, basically. Okay, so what else we have got to cover? Because I don't want to make this very long. Battle Arena. Oh yeah. Let's see some pay to win. This beauty. Okay, whatever. This guy didn't die. No, he didn't die. Just keep trying. But you see how fast his attack is going up. Basically, pay to win in a nutshell. Something is going to go through the roof if you are pay to win. Either it's going to be attack, either it's going to be some particular skill, but something is going to be very extreme and you're not going to deal with it on a regular basis. And the cards which I have are close to the very, very top. So this is one of the very best that free to play has to offer. I guess I should try to get to a higher level if I succeed in this show off. Because we are 5 levels. We are levels 1 to 20. But on most levels you just get points and you just level up. On the final 5 levels you can either go up or down. So you can either go to higher level or lower level. So for example, at this particular level, if I win, I always get 10 points. But if I lose on this particular level, I will lose 50 points. If I am at level 23, I will lose 10 points. If I'm at level 2, I will lose 30 points. And if I'm at level 23, I will lose 40 points. Victory is always 10 points. Loss is the last level 40. So you need to have something extreme like 90% to get anywhere on the maximum level. And also, while you are being idle, you can be attacked by other players. So, for example, I attacked some random player, I defeated him. So, his rating got decreased by a couple points too. So, in order to stay high ranked, you need to win a lot. Yes, I don't really care. I don't really care whether I win and I just auto-skip all my battles because... I guess I'll show this to you because I don't really have much point of talking about these cards. I said, this is pay to win, it's really pay to win. And if you play versus pay to win player, you lose. And if you play versus free to play player, you probably win. Because in the battles, you go first and you are the first one to put the card. So, battles are basically very straightforward. You either win or you either lose. That's most often the outcome of particular matches are the predetermined, because the simple quality of decks are just the difference is just extreme. For example, this is very grinding experience. And for example, one stamina needed to play one battle in arena that charges every 15 minutes. And it's a 50 stamina cap. So it's like I need to log in every 4 hours to play these battles, and these battles are just repeated more of the same. A lot of decks are more or less the same because a lot of cards, for example, for free to play are limited. There could be not that many cards for free to play which are actually good, so there's a lot of repetition, there's a lot of boring stuff. It just gets very grindy overall. So what I do, I just auto skip. Auto skip all the time, auto skip it all the time. Here we go, everything is done! Yeah, we are out of energy! I guess that's more or less all for this video, yeah! I wonder why in particular I did rate this 1 star. Oh, maybe I should check store one more time. Whatever other deals. Ooh, elite pack, pay $15 to get some benefits. Oh, the better deal. Intelligent people never use this because developers often release stuff like this. You spend $100. Get 4,000 war bonds. Beautiful. Oh, whatever costs here? 60 war bonds per pool. No, not good. Basically, to buy out the anti-box, need to spend more than on one game, on one AAA game. And these cards very quickly get outdated. Like, for example, I give this 6 months a top, and all these cards are going to be outdated. So, you can spend hundreds of and hundreds of dollars, and all you get will get outdated soon. So, you need to be very rich if you're going into this kind of game. Oh, more choice. Wow, so basically you need to make some calculation. Which one of these packs will give you the most value? Wow. So much choice to make. So much temptation to blew all your money. Wow. Oh, this one is great. 150 salvage points. I think that's like a couple hours of grinding, so I will remind you the cost. That is $5. $5, and in a day you could easily get these 150 salvage points. So basically, we are 30 days in a month, so $150 necessary just to double your flow of money, or in this case, salvage points. Expensive. Oh, some of these packs. Are they shitting me? What is the cost? 150 war bonds. And each consecutive purchase increases the price. This card even has an outdated skill named Valor. It was updated to the skill name Bravery. So you know this card is old. You know this card is crap. And they're selling it. The developers are literally trying to trick the players into buying this crap so they would waste their money and later they would realize that they got cheated and that we have no way to get paid back for wasting their money on this. Yes, and that's one card, you just buy it and you get this card. One crappy card. What is it? $10. No, $15 for a crappy card. Oh my God! But anyways, what is this one? Super epic pack. Oh, some crappy cards. Well, but at least all these cards can be upgraded. They can really be used to fuse something good. So at least that's something going for them. Okay, now let's see. What else do we have? Oh my, $20. So we just got some mono faction. But all these cards are free to play, so free to play is pretty weak. So you are just buying materials which are free to play warrior, more or less. These are cancerous. Cancerous offers! Okay, this one, last one. Oh. Are these even supposed to be good? Well, I guess they are supposed to be good. But all these cards are singles, more or less. I believe this is not a quadra pack. In quadra pack, at least you get four copies of the same card. Here you get four random cards, so you probably will need to hope to get enough of them to fuse them. Again, lottery, gambling, oh my God, the prices. Like literally, I could just set the entire time here and just keep rambling. The prices, the grind, the hell is wrong with this game? Okay. So, plus 10 card slots. 10 war bonds. No, thank you. Basically, now I have 225 war bonds. Basically, I got 180 war bonds once because developers released one broken event. It was very broken, had a lot of bugs in it. So, they rewarded the entire community with 180 war bonds. And I got 360 war bonds later. Very recently, because developers decided that it's time to celebrate 5-year anniversary. So, I got some war bonds and I spent them on getting plus 50 max energy. I think I spent 350 war bonds on that plus 50 energy. And each max energy increases the price. So, the prices are going through the roof. Oh my, what's this one? Ah, old story. Okay, and I got over a million. I guess I'll spend seven. No, I will just spend. I guess I'll buy some packs. This is what I wanted to tell. Oh, I got 20 crappy cards. Amazing, let's keep buying. Oh my god, again! Oh, I'm blowing up all the gold like it was Christmas. And I'm still getting crap. Okay, let's persist. Will we get at least one good card? Will we get at least one? Oh, we are not even allowed to continue to buy because I ran out of card space. Oh, imagine my shock about this. Oh, I need to salvage stuff. Okay. Okay, now I got like 150, maybe 200 salvage points from that. So one quad requires like 2000 salvage points. So just make my calculations. I basically to make one full card, I need to go back and forth 10 times something at this rate. And by the way, there's limit on salvage points too, so you can't really go to infinity. You are forced to spend. And for example, I save a lot of this crap to salvage later because it's much better to waste gold and expend all the gold because the gold will give all the base set cards. So spend all the gold and then you know what base cards you have and what quads you can make. So basically, spending all this million will take so much time, like it take hours. Hours just to craft your one card. Hours just to craft all my deck, because 1 million means I probably will be crafting my whole deck. So it's going to be one full day me spending, upgrading, grinding, doing all this stuff, just clicking again and again and again just to upgrade my deck to its full better potential. Do you feel the grind with this game? The cash grab, the pay to win. Like for example, I probably would have left this game very, very long ago, but it just happens that I became a guild leader. So there are 49 people who depend on me, so I want to help them, and I want them to feel happy, to have some joy. It appears that they still enjoy this game. I guess I enjoy the game too, but it's just at a very minimal levels of enjoyment. But I really enjoy is helping these people, giving them advices on how to play, how to improve their decks and etc. Oh, I'll also. Well, if not for the guild, I will not be playing this game anymore. The guild does not matter so much, it's probably the case for many more players. So also just final note on the artwork. Because this is the third version of Tyrant. It was Tyrant the first. So when it was something different, but then it was Tyrant the second, and then, now it's Tyrant the third. So basically, each Tyrant was killed, destroyed. Developers simply refused to keep updating it, and they would rather release a new brand level. New brand game, I mean. And in the process, we destroyed all the guilds. Like for example, second version of Tyrant, because the one considering to be the best, the one with much less pay to win. That version had Tyrant fan site. There was like another web page. You open that web page and it has a lot of statistics, a lot of great stuff about what guilds there are, how many points the guilds get, how which guilds are growing in the rankings, which guilds are falling in the rankings. What suggested decks to build certain mission and etc. But developers decided to kill the previous game, and that means that the fan site died with it. So what's the point of creating these fan sites? Like this version of Tyrant doesn't have a fan site, and good grief! I hope that I'll be able to record this. Let's see how much care these developers are giving to the wiki. Wicked, you may own project. Okay, here we go, here we go, here we go. Okay, Tyrant Unleashed Wiki. Okay, is this getting recorded? Yes, this is getting recorded. I just got the missions. I got the missions quick. I have to show us. I have to show us just how little care this gets. How little care is given for this particular game. Quick. Oh, now here we go. So, somewhere around May 20, 2015, so the developers just started to give zero shit about this game. And this after that, all the updates to Tyrant Unleashed Wiki stopped. Well, there are some updates, but basically they're very few and very far in between. People stopped giving them. So if you want information on this particular game, you better use Google, some search engine like Tyrant Unleashed, and you just go to Kongregate forums to find all the information you need. And also, a lot of these updates are not known. If you want to go, you must go to this forum in the game itself. You won't know what is up, what's going to happen. Like basically, oh. Like roadmap. That's the only place where you can find what's going to happen. Here we go. Now the other thing which I remembered, typing. Okay, so we type, and I cannot see what is written before. If I want to go back, I cannot. I need to literally erase my text. If I click somewhere else, like for example, I click somewhere outside of this. For example, I will decrease this. Now I'm back into this. Like I minimize my window. Now I'm back, and I clicked back. It's gone. All I wrote is gone, and it's a PC version. So PC version is at least tolerable when it comes to writing stuff. You won't believe what is on tablet. I tried it once. You have to write text, and you get what usual. Tablet prompt, tablet keyboard and the stuff. But the text which you write is the same color as the background. Background is white and text font is white too. So you don't see what you are typing. And also, if you write some wrong characters here, like for example, I will write some Lithuanian characters. I don't even see what I'm writing. It might appear to me that it's not, nothing is written. So when I write something in English and I post it. But what would happen here is that, oh my god, it will be full of random numbers. Because all these foreign characters will still be here, I just don't see them. And the chat room will display these characters. And they will be some random numbers. And also, look at the size of this chat room. Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go, here we go. That's the limit of a chat room. The more we write, and the old stuff just simply gets erased. So if you want to have a long conversation, you need to rely on external sources. Like for example, my guild uses Discord. Some guilds use Lines. Maybe some guilds use Kongregate messages, but they are not perfect either. Basically, there are a lot of things which need care in this game, and the game is not getting that care. A lot of this crappy stuff was gone for years, and it's still going to go. For example, I'm pretty sure this game is going to get killed at one point. And the moment this game is gets killed, I will never go back to it. I had enough. I had enough of developers literally disregarding the players. I had enough of developers trying to milk as much money as they can. For example, I will scroll down. Oh my, this game is considered to have 4-star rating. But what were the top comments? What are the top comments on the Kongregate? Oh, I will read this quality. I will read it just for you. These prices are outrageous. Oh, that's one comment. Wow, the packs are more expensive than the regular card games. Yeah, you buy one pack, and that's more expensive than the entire card pack. Like, one card costs something like 60 warbons, and that's like $5. So, yeah, you could buy a full card deck for that money. Oh, dear Congregate, please stop badging games to the energy systems. Thank you. Yeah, look, we have some achievements. Wow, some. You want to get some points on Congregate? Come to this game and waste your time. Waste your time on some shitty missions. Some boring to go through. My God. And why did they add this achievements? Like, this is a complete gambling game. Like, some people might get addicted to it and they might waste hundreds upon hundreds of money on this. And, like, this is no joke. Because basically, this is false advertisement because this is said to be free game. Yeah, free to lose. Feel free to lose as much as possible. Free to be shit. Free to never become the top player. Free to never be compete. Because you know your level. You are trash. If you're free to play player, you are trash. We are normal people. People who buy. People who waste hundreds upon hundreds of dollars. And we are people who are trash. People who are at the bottom. Yeah, we are clear caste systems. Like, you know your place, you need to know your place. And as a free player, I made it. They steal crap. Like, for example, we have some campaign events, and doing was there are three types of missions. We have easy types, which for beginners, normal types, for players like me, and then there's pay to win types. Like, there's even segregated what you can play. And which you cannot play, and yeah, you can try to play, which you cannot play, but you will lose always. Like, there's a hard limit on how high you can go. To fully experience this game, you have to pay money, and the amount of that money is egregious. My God, I'm probably literally shorting my life expectancy by going through this game. Oh, thanks, Congregate, thanks, Tyrant Unleashed. Thank you, Mr. Synapticon. Thank you, Mr. Davain33. Thank you, Mr. Ojotel. And by the way, you can go to Congregate and check some of these comments for yourself. I might have missed some things, but if you're looking for some games to start, avoid this game like fire. Trust me. Well, if you might have something to enjoy here. Which is a mere fact that you are playing this game and endorses with developers to continue to practice the horrible cash grabbing tactics. They pay to win. A pay to win model will continue to be used if many free players to continue to play this game. I care for my guild and I care for my players, that's why I'm not quitting myself. But I made a promise, I will not play the next game I release. I'm blocking these developers. These developers have proven themselves to be greedy and uncaring. Like, for example, now we have a one game called Spellstone, and all the development more or less goes to this particular game. And this game, Tyrant, is just a backup. So basically, it works like this: we release a new game, and game starts to decline because, of course, how could it sustain with such business model? And then we secretly develop another game. When we release the game and when there are two games going on at the same time. And they go on like this, and now we have two games. The older game gets more or less ignored. And then they start creating the third game. And the old game finally gets destroyed and the developers release second game. So that game which was released in the middle, now that game becomes the ignored one. And that's the cycle of these developers. Yeah, it was going for very long. If you liked what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, or subscribe. I will greatly appreciate any of your feedback. If you have suggestions, what shall I cover next? Let me know. I'm a poor person, so more or less only three options are available to me. So, anyways, if you for some reason you enjoyed the game, because well, the gameplay could be fun, I guess. The artwork is fine. But the grind, but the pay to win, oh my. Yes, I was going on this game for way too long. So, anyways, thank you for watching this.
Also, thank you, my viewers, for suggesting this. And bye, and see you in my next video.